الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. The ulama, the scholars, are the warathal anbiya. They're the inheritors of the prophets, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam told us. And what are some of the benefits of studying with the scholars in Islam? The benefits are many, because for one, if you study with the major scholars, you're in that silsila, that chain. And the religion was based on the isnad, based on the chain of narration, to where you have scholars in this time that have taken from scholars who have taken from other scholars and other scholars, all the way up to the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And this is one benefit. It's not in their bloodline, but it's in fact because of their tarbiyah, the way they were educated, the way they were raised. They were raised dealing with issues in Masail, memorizing the Quran, memorizing the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then you benefit from that. You benefit from their ilm and their wisdom. Another benefit is that they have hikmah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man yuridu Allahu bihi khayran yafaqahu fid din." Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for a person, He gives him understanding of the religion. So that's a sign that Allah wants good for a person, and that characteristic we find with the ulama, the scholars. That hikmah, that ilm, the knowledge, the wisdom, the understanding of the deen, the understanding. Because it's not simply a matter of even just learning Arabic. How many of us don't even know Arabic and we still want to make fatawa? We still want to try to have munaqashat or discuss issues. But without even the Arabic, which is just a minimal tool. Because the Arabs, it's not because they're Arabs that they know the religion, no. But it's those who have studied amongst them, and those who have studied amongst the Indonesians and amongst the various African countries and everything from Australia to America. It's from studying. It's from seeking knowledge. Talib al-ilm. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Talib al-ilm faridatun ala kulli Muslim." That seeking the knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim and Muslima. Talib al-ilm faridatun ala kulli Talib al-ilm faridatun ala kulli Muslim wa Muslima. So seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim and Muslima. And the scholars, they explain for us that this is ilm al-wajib, meaning that everyone should have a certain degree of knowledge. Not everyone's going to sit under the beards of the ulama and be patient with that life and the harms that it is on the body and travel to seek knowledge and all the various ways to seek that knowledge. But it comes from but everyone must have a certain degree of knowledge. Everyone must know how to pray. Everyone must know purification. Everyone must know if they have wealth, they must know how to pay zakat. If they have the ability to make hajj, they must learn how to make hajj. If they are into business, then they must know kitab al-biyur. They must know the condition, know how to sell and buy, and what constitutes riba or usury or interest, and all the various the various rulings pertaining to that. We have to know what is an obligation upon us, and that is the knowledge which is an obligation upon every believer. So it's not sufficient just to say I'm a Muslim and never open a book, and never listen to a lecture, never listen to a small statement of even your imam reading from Riyadh al-Salihin or Arba'in al-Nawawi or whatever book that they're reading. No, do something for your soul, because seeking knowledge is food for the soul. And the ulama, akhsha ibadi al-ulama, the most fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's slaves is the scholars. Why? Because they have knowledge and they practice that knowledge. Seeking the knowledge, al-ilm, وَالْعَمَلُ بِهِ, knowledge and practicing the knowledge. And that is the state of the ulama. Those are the ones, the warath al-anbiya, they're the inheritors of the prophets, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam. And that's because of their knowledge and their fiqh and their wisdom and their age. If you're able to take from the major scholars and those who are, you know, elders, that they've been through the experience in life, the experience in the deen, and the knowledge in the deen, and they have all of those things combined, you see a difference in their understanding of the religion and how they pass fatawa and how they transmit knowledge, their uslub, their suluk, This comes from knowledge and fiqh and being an elder and being from the kibar ulama and being from, you know, the major scholars and those people who have, it's like a if you have tea, green tea for example, and you put it in a cup of hot water, they've been steeped in there. They've steeped in the knowledge. Whereas someone else, maybe even the younger scholars that have a lot of benefit, immense benefit for us, but they haven't steeped in that experience of life and steeped in those masail. They haven't sat and dealt with issues and entrenched themselves in issues. Because we have some scholars that have been dealing with masail and issues in those books that we're just learning about. They dealt with those books and they've been teaching those books for 40 years and more, teaching the six sunans. So of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored them. So that's why I encourage myself and encourage those who are listening to seek knowledge from the scholars and to learn the Arabic language, because that's just a minimal tool. If you don't know Arabic, then you should keep fairly silent about the religion. It's fine, you're learning, you're sitting in classes, and that's beautiful if you have the desire to do so. But what kind of issues can you discuss without the Arabic language? That's just a key to get to some of the source books, because then you have no strong usul. You have to get the strong foundation in issues. If you're going to talk about fiqh, well, you need to be able to go to fiqh books and see what are the aqwal of the ulama. Otherwise, you'll just maybe be making your religion based on fatawa only. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah, and anything I said incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.